Dozens of suspected violent criminals are identified.
And half of them are behind bars tonight after federal and local authorities executed a large undercover sting. WLKY's Ann Bowden spoke with the agents involved in this crackdown. Ann?
Well, Rick and Vicki, the majority of charges involved illegal drug and firearm offenses uncovered by a joint investigation by the ATF, the U.S. District Attorney's Office, and local law enforcement. Agents called the major sting Operation Around the Horn.
Just Around the Horn is just an operational name, again, just the idea that we were going to target the community, the violent crime in the community, and kind of cover all the bases.
It's a baseball term.
And covering all the bases to bring down violent crime in southern Indiana scored more than 40 suspected criminals.
The defendants behind us are made up of 35 state defendants, charges that are coming out of my office.
The seven-month-long sting by undercover officers, the ATF, and several southern Indiana sheriff's departments also identified three federal offenders and four new cases. Out of that number, early this morning, with warrants in hand, agents arrested 23.
We're still in the process of completing the arrest of a number of defendants that was a product of a federal and state investigation.
The charges involve serious federal drug trafficking in marijuana, methamphetamine, cocaine, oxycodone, hydrocodone, synthetic marijuana, and another discovery.
Was an increase in heroin.
The charges also involved trafficking in deadly weapons, handguns, pistols, and revolvers. While this was a significant sting operation, this task force says it's not over.
My office intends to aggressively pursue these charges and to continue to send the message that if you come to this community and deal drugs or you deal firearms, you'll be held accountable.
Now, right now, there are 12 state defendants that are still at large. The prison terms these criminals face range from 1 to 50 years. And Henderson says more arrests are likely because while he wouldn't confirm this was organized crime, he did say that there was a common thread to all these arrests. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.